I just ran a checkup on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people.
Coach, thanks. Located appropriately for his career win total at 347 Don Shula Drive. There's a look at Hard Rock Stadium here in Miami, Florida. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Dallas Cowboys and the Miami Dolphins. The first 2 months of the regular season down. What will the final two bring us as we're off in week 9? This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Play at second down.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. From the gun, Jackson. And he's got his man on the out route. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. This defense looking for an early stop. This is third down and 6. Jackson from the shotgun, flush to his right. And that will be incomplete. Not the opening possession they were looking for, especially on the road.
No doubt about it, because they wanted to come out and establish a little momentum right away. But now bringing up a fourth down, an empty possession, not what they were seeking.
And this will pin them back deep. That's going to kick out of bounds right at about the 7-yard line. The field position game, such an overlooked facet, Charles, of an NFL game, but this offense, they're going to be pinned back. What an ideal punt.
An ideal punt, and it leads to that term complementary football, because them doing that puts their defense in a great spot, doesn't it? Gives them a chance. If they want to be aggressive, try and maybe get a safety out of this whole thing, it puts them in that position.
Down throw for Mariota. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
There are a good number of coaches that anytime they call an in route are really worried about the play, because there's so much traffic ordinarily that the ball has to get through to get to the receiver. And on that play, it was batted down.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Mariota to throw it. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Even the greats in this game, and he certainly qualifies as one of them, they're going to have trouble if they continue to throw into double coverage.
He better be careful. Throwing into too much double coverage might have a couple of them picked off. Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions.
59 is Mike, 59 is Mike. Check, 59. You remember me? You remember me? Let's go, baby. Mike's 59.
From the gun, Mariota. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Better drop something else, baby.
Here's Matt Hawk now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. He was called on three times in the win last week as his first one here's away. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And a three and out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody goes out a little extra.
And he will go down outside of the pocket for a sack. Tried to get away but could not. Montez Sweat in there to get him. It's a loss of five. Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15. And that one covered beautifully. Their defenders stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line. He was trying to get that one to Allen that time, but now it'll be third down. This time, Jackson will throw it. Now he'll let this one go deep, right sideline. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee.
Here we go.
Attention paid this week in practice to red zone offense. The coach was optimistic about how it went. We'll see. Stepping up, he'll try and run. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Taking it in from the 20. As his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. So a designed run all the way, and he took it the distance. I don't know that anybody saw that come.
Well, on this play, how about the vision of him, being able to see the open field, make his move, and get there. Oftentimes, defenses have a spy for the quarterback position to try and take care of it. On that play, if they did, it certainly didn't
work.
Yeah, there's no doubt.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And it's only November, but the playoffs, we know how it works. They'll be here before you know it. If it ended today, they would be the number one seed.
And that's a great spot to be in, but I love the phrase, if it ended today. And I guarantee you, That's what they've discussed in their locker room, in their meeting rooms. Yeah, we know where we'd be if it ended today, but we also know it's not ending today.
Right.
So they've got to continue to play the type of ball that put them in the spot where they're number one in their conference.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Mariota. Quick hitter here, it's complete. That throw good for four. It's second down. Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one.
Right here.
Throwing again on second down. Mariota. Right, and that's complete. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 44-yard line.
I like that one, partner. They go back-to-back with excellent gains. And really, it shouldn't be a surprise who they were throwing the ball to. He's their best guy.
Yeah, we knew that they would get him involved early. They're doubling down on getting him involved early.
Don't be surprised if they'll come right back to him again. They haven't shown the propensity to be able to stop him.
Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Brings up second and nine at the 43-yard line.
Hey, new 18.
Hey.
One.
Two is the mic. Mic by two. All right, take off.
On second and nine, Mariota eluding the pressure right. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down. The first down line at the 34 here on third down. Now Mariota. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Bailey. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 32-yard line.
First and 10 at the 32-yard line.
Come on,
dude.
That's the pass. Move. One.
52's the mic right here, over there, right?
Fox trap.
On first and 10, here's Mariota. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. 25 yards that time. So on that play, defense was in the zone. They ran a crossing route offensively, but the defense there, you got to be good with communication, don't you?
You certainly do, and it's not something that is really evident when you watch it on the screen.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Carl Joseph. And now nothing but green ahead of him. And he'll take this across midfield and inside the 45. I tell you what, credit is due there on them preventing the touchdown after that interception.
How about him chasing him down and not giving up the pick six? Because what happens a lot of the time is when you see the interception, you just kind of hang your head a little bit and you momentarily pause because you're frustrated. He shook that off and gave great chase and got it done.
Still a great return and very good field position. And now a throw here secured by his running back out of the backfield.
The gain of seven brings up second and three.
Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. Nine yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
Well, if you're going to run the read option, typically, you've got to keep an eye on the defensive end.
And what does that mean? What are you looking for with a defensive end?
Well, you want to play off of what he does. If he collapses inside towards the running back, then you pull it and take it yourself outside in. If he stays outside, you go ahead and leave it with the running back. In this case, pulled it and got good yardage himself.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Marcus Davenport there to take him down.
That's it. Big hit. A 3-yard pickup brings up second and seven. at the Dolphins' 24-yard line.
Shut! Not a wolf. Get Mike. Oh, watch one, watch one. Watch the safety creep.
From the 24, Jackson flushed out right. That is caught inside the 5. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. A great play there. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further. Point after, right down the middle. And it's now 14 to nothing. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. And they're in an early hole. The first drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown. So, decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. Now then, after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. 14-0 to score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Now then, after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. Off the play fake, Mariota. Trying to lay one up deep. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. A big play there for the Dolphins. 52 yards. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
And this is going to be hauled in. Oh, what a catch at the 10. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
First and goal at the 9-yard line.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. From the shotgun, it's Mariota. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. Bryce Love, his third touchdown now on the year, as they are now on the board here in the first half. See, it seemed like they were so focused on the guys out wide, they forgot about him out of the backfield.
That's a really good point, because you've got to communicate, and oftentimes when you start counting receivers, that's exactly what you do. You start from the widest receiver, work your way inside. Who gets lost sometimes? The back in the backfield. That's exactly what happened there.
And he got into the end zone. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive.
He's got a man complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. That goes for a gain of 31. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 13 yards and a first down, Cowboys.
Check 55, Mike.
room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain there as he kept it himself at second down.
No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10 at the 29-yard line.
Time he'll look to throw. Buying time to his left. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down.
They just gave up a sack there, and if I'm not mistaken, they gave up four last week, didn't they?
Yes. And just looking really porous, aren't they?
They really are, and I'm wondering if I'm going to have to start thinking about keeping the tight end in, maybe a back, someone to help assist, because right now, their quarterback's been getting hit a lot in the last couple of games.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this down to about the 30, 31-yard line. Give him 3 yards there as that'll take us to fourth down. So on fourth down here, Mike Tomlin says, let's just get three. On the left hash, this from 48 yards. And his kick is good. And they will move up by 10 now, 17-7. So a good kick there to polish off the drive with 3 points.
Yeah, coaches always talk about finishing a drive with a kick. Two of them give you points, either an extra point or, in this case, a field goal.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to...
It comes, and he lost the football. Mariota had it jarred loose. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And this is going to be brought back for a fumble return touchdown by the Cowboys. So the big fella gets on the scoreboard with a return for a touchdown. Good thing he didn't have to go too far, though.
You know the trainers were very happy about that. Imagine having to go get him in the end zone, escort him to the bench, and give him the oxygen. They were loving the fact that he got in without having to run very far.
Extra point right down the middle. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And let's just say they're going to be looking to start over on this drive. A few moments ago, they were in the exact situation, but their first play led to a fumble that was returned for six.
Yeah, you definitely have to have a short memory to play in the NFL. You got to remember what you did wrong so you don't repeat it. But you can't dwell on it because then you will.
And they get to Mariota here as he's dropped on the sack. T.J. Watt, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Here's Mariota. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down.
A gain of 14 yards brings up third down.
So a third and 9, and 6 defensive backs out there in the dime.
Patrolling the passing lanes.
Working out of the gun, Mariota. And he fires one that's intercepted. He's picked off just shy of midfield. And they will be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20.
When a team's turned it over three times in the first half, we just look at the offense and say, guys, what are you doing? But instead, we really should be looking at the defense. They've created the takeaways. Two interceptions, one caused fumble. They played awfully well swarming to the ball here in the first half.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL.
Right over there, right over there. Yeah. Mike, 58, right there.
Man up.
58, the mic. 58, the mic.
Throwing on second down, Jackson. And he's wrapped up, taken down, back at the 25. Marcus Davenport, credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of six. The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. Close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And his kick is indeed good, and that will push this lead up to 20 now. So he splits the uprights, and has to be a nice feeling. Right when it left his foot, knew it was good.
Yeah, just like a good three-point shooter in basketball, right? Release the ball, fall back on defense without even looking. You know it's going in the hoop.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You could never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
So a challenge coming down from the booth, and that's where these challenges come from, of course, in the final 2 minutes of the half.
Yeah, and now we're going to New York, right? That's command central for the officials. They'll talk, they'll take a look at it, communicate with the referee at the game site, and issue a final decision because they do have the final call now.
First down, Mariota. Man open left side, it's his running back with it. A big play there just before halftime. 44 yards. Obviously, they're not where they want to be right now on the scoreboard. Big plays like that, though, that'll trend them in the right direction.
Yeah, a few more like that, they'll be right back in the game. And if they can continue to do that, maybe they'll inspire their defense as well and get a few stops.
So now following the big play, they've got a first and goal all the way down at the 10.
Single receiver. Bravo!
To throw is Mariota. And that's incomplete.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
Three.
Tight end's right. Nice seven, let's go.
Three down. 31's the mic.
They'll throw again. Mariota. And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. Antonio Callaway, his first touchdown on the year. And the Dolphins are able to cut into this lead. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And that cuts this lead down to 13. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. No return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Cowboys take over first and
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. You've got under a minute to go here until halftime. You got the good size lead. No need to do anything crazy.
No, there really is no need to do anything crazy. The smart play, go ahead and take your lead into the locker room and then try and add to it in the second half. But there's a part of me that looks at this and says, first half going my way, I have a little bit of a cushion. Let's go ahead and try and extend things. If you've got some good plays drawn up, you might want to think about them right here.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25.
Watch the run. Check.
To throw again. Jackson. Dancing to his left. Wide open receiver complete. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. From the gun, it's Jackson. Escaping the pressure right. Oh, that was dangerous. Threw it into coverage, almost picked. But instead, they'll keep it on second down. Pretty lucky to get the football back. Had his target out there waving the arms, saying I'm open, but maybe he didn't see him quick enough.
And I know the jokes are always about defensive backs' hands. What really actually happens, you don't get many opportunities, you get over-anxious, and you start to think about taking it away and going the other way instead of focusing and catching the ball.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout, as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a third and 10.
55, my guy, 55. You're trapped. Check, 55 to Mike. Check, 55 to Mike. And come on, now, run it.
To throw again is Jackson. And almost picked off. I guess the good news for them now, it's fourth down. Out now comes the Cowboys punter, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. Time here for likely one play, then off to the locker room, and they're going to have some adjustments to make.
They certainly will, and I think a lot of people are thinking to themselves, all right, take the knee, get out of here.
That's caught inside the 20, and he's in for the touchdown on the final play of the first half. The prayer is answered.
How did they get that done? Brandon, my man, just one sentence for that one. Clinic.
And that's what they've done. They lead the league in points per game this season, but it's been quick strike ability, as we saw on that drive.
I think they're actually intimidating defenses because they're back on their heels right away, wondering where it's going to come from, how they're going to hit them. This group is well organized, well coached, and extremely confident in what they do.
It's been a shootout so far. We'll see which defense can make the adjustments as we get back underway in the second half. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over.
And he lost the football. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line. Well, they came out of the locker trailing. Not a good way to start the second half with their first drive.
Can't imagine that the discussion at halftime encompassed this at all. In fact, I'm sure they talked about, okay, kind of wipe the slate clean, start the second half, and let's go out and play the way we know that we can. That's not a great example of it.
They didn't envision that. Now, the first play of the drive there is incomplete. The intended receiver there, Allen, that'll bring up second down. Looked like he had a couple of different options as far as who to throw to on that play. And who am I to say this, but I'm not sure he made the right decision.
Well, the window of opportunity is always going to be small in the NFL. That's why those quarterbacks who make quick decisions and have quick releases have the most success in this league.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Now a stoppage here as it looks like we've got a Dolphin shaking up on the play. We'll get an update when we come back to Hard Rock Stadium. They'll throw on first down with Jackson, letting one go deep for the end zone. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Snags it for the pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
I know some teams are leery about playing cover two because a strong safety is not usually a terrific cover guy. But in this case, he played it perfectly, read the football, and went and made the interception.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get...
And this will be caught at the 30. It's a big play there for Miami. 51 yards. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator is looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. T.J. Watt, make that now 8 sacks for him on the season. So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range.
31's the mic, Charlie.
Let's go.
31's the mic.
All day, dog.
Mariota. And the pressure gets to him again.
My man, it's been a rough night for that offensive line, and it's only getting rougher. 5 sacks now that they've given up in this contest so far. It feels like the witching hour out here, doesn't it?
Okay, stupid question. What's the witching hour?
Yeah, the witching hour. That's when everything goes haywire late at night.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Throwing is Mariota. He's going to go for a big play downfield. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down.
I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the Autobahn. Everybody just flying by, and these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some good numbers put up against them offensively. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. We have not seen much on offense here from either side these last few drives. We've hit a wall, so to speak.
And have hit it hard, haven't we? Because the defenses right now, they seem to be a step ahead, don't they? Beating them to the point of attack, beating them to the punch. These offensive guys, they're tinkering like crazy. What's it going to take to get back on track?
Yeah, both sides searching for adjustments. Second and inches. Jackson got a man open. That's Harry. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Give them 15 there, and the Cowboys have a first.
Well, for teams that like to play man coverage, running corner routes can be tough on them because of the ability of getting into it. Sometimes you're squaring it off. Sometimes you're just rounding it. Sometimes there's a fake. Sometimes there's not. That makes it very, very difficult for a DB to stay with it.
Throwing on first down, it's Jackson. Flush to his right. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. The completion good for 3, and it's second down.
51 the mic, boys. 51.
And he probably should have given that one off as he's going to get hit and taken down behind the line. The tally there, minus 2 yards, brings up third down. Jackson got his man. That's Harry, and he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 37.
And another thing that makes the comeback route really effective is that oftentimes after you've made the initial move, receivers breaking away from the defensive back, and that makes it a really tough play to defend. A nice chunk of yardage picked up there.
Jackson now, after the pick on the last drive, 3 for 3 to start this drive. It's first and 10.
He's coming. Double up, double up.
Now they try the right side here. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. It's a gain of 12, and the Cowboys pick up the first.
A good run there off right tackle in an old-school NFL football. The right side of the offensive line, often known as the nasty side. The left side, usually the technical side. Kind of reminds me of the old Atlanta Falcons 2009-2010. That's how they constructed their offensive line.
And give him about 3 as he gets it down to the 22-yard line. From the 22, Jackson, and he's going to go down. They sack him back right around the 30.
Brandon, more often than not, you'd say they've had his number, and we can count them up so far. 1, 2, 3, 4 sacks given up. But guess what? He's still been able to make some plays, and right now they have a lead.
Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long.
Alert three, alert three, alert three.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he does not get to the first down marker as they stop him at the 19. They'll get 11, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive. Because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense getting a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. And this one is right through. And that will make this a 9-point lead. So he remains perfect, 3 for 3 in the field goal department.
And it's so important for any offense to have an ace like him up their sleeve, isn't it? Because now you know what his range is, and as soon as your offense gets there, you're pretty much counting on 3 points going up on the board.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
He's going to sling this deep downfield. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
Throwing again on 2nd and 10. Mariota, and they take over. They'll set up shop at the 46-yard line. That is now 7 interceptions between last week and this week. 3 in this game, 4 a week ago.
And I saw the head coach write on his play sheet, make a little note. I hope he's writing self-scout. Bring in the guys that scout games for you with a different eye and watch him and see what's going on.
Touchdown, Cowboys! A big play there. His 4th touchdown on the year. And the Cowboys turn that interception into a touchdown. To to throw is Jackson. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite. But in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed near the goal line on a two-point conversion, all that exit, you know, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. Throwing, Mariota. Throw left side, complete. It's Love. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Dolphins on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This will be third and 6.
31's the mic. Watch the twist.
They go play action. Mariota. Eluding the pressure right. And that'll wind up incomplete. Bold play call there. Now it's fourth down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it.
Mike 52.
We ain't giving up nothing today.
Box track.
Mike 2 is the mic.
One.
All day, every day, any day.
Hey, Mike 52.
Now Mariota on fourth down. He's going to air one out. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception picked up by Carl Joseph. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. Yet another interception, and I just had to double-check my math. But it is now 8 between last week and this week.
Well, I just used a calculator. I didn't worry about double-checking it. But the thing that always throws me when you see quarterbacks in this type of a bad spot, they're trying to figure
out. And intercepted, maybe the turning point they need. Picked off at the 38. And nearly a touchdown as they finally stop him down at about the 3-yard line. That's now his second interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has to employ in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man-to-man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, and excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility and showing those hands.
I don't think any of us were surprised that they decided to start this drive on the ground after the last two drives ended in interceptions.
Unfortunately, though, not a lot going on that first play.
Yeah, I think the anticipation was felt also by the defense.
From the 2 now, second and goal. They'll try to run this one in. And he takes it into the end zone for the Dolphin touchdown. A great effort there with touchdown number 7 on the year. As they're now just an extra point away from getting back within one score. Extra point up and good by Sanders as this gets him back within a touchdown and a two-point conversion. after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. This will be taken in at the one. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line.
Let's go!
At their own 25-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. I'm curious to see, Charles, about the play calling on this drive. Last time out, the interception that led to a touchdown. Here we are. I mean, very close. One score game.
Yeah, and if I'm a defender, I'm actually chirping to you on the other side of the ball, saying, hey, we picked off the last one. What you going to do about it now? So when you do throw the football, high percentage, but throw it with confidence. If there's any hesitancy at all, it could end up in enemy's hands again.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Jackson steps away to his left. And he's going to keep it here. 8 yards that time, able to take off, and the result is a first down.
How many times have we seen this late in the fourth quarter? Because you know the pass rush is getting after him, and they get upfield, get that great push, and what do they create? Space, and he takes off.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Off the play fake, here's Jackson. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Jackson now. Flushed out right. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. He was out there waving his arms, and when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
To throw is Jackson on third down. And Jackson cannot get away, and he'll go down. Defense went 3-4. They got some push from the inside.
And this is something in a 3-4 you don't normally get, because the nose tackle who got the sack, he's usually responsible or ends up getting double teamed and sometimes triple teamed. How about him working his way back and putting the big guy on the ground?
So well done there. And these punters, they get more specialized and better each and every year, don't they?
They sure do. And now it's really not the American punters. It's the Australian punters with their kicking academies and that flat drop and just kind of kicking the nose of the football. They're able to almost stop it where they want to, like a good golfer can check one up.
Mariota on first down.
Oh, boy, he got a favorable spot there. The guys on the sidelines were raising their hands over their head and clasping their hands to signal safety. But the official marked it just outside the end zone at the one-yard line.
Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. Out of his end zone, Mariota. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. The catch and run pays off for 29 yards. Catch number 100 for his career right there, and it's good enough to keep the chains moving. A first down throw for Mariota. That's taken in by Callaway. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. So second and eight here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. They'll try the left side. Slater. And the hole closes quickly. He gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line. The Dolphins on third down, just one for five to this point. This will be third and five. Mariota. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. DeMarcus Lawrence. Make that now 8 sacks for him on the season. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
Make these babies
alpha. Where's 52? Watch 52. 52 is the mic.
Watch the run. Watch the run.
Mariota to throw for it on fourth. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off at the 45. And they will set up shop in enemy territory at the 42-yard line. Gosh, you add up last week and this week now. That's 9 interceptions in this 2-game stretch, and we're not done here.
It's almost as if they can't even believe their eyes. Or maybe, partner, is the confidence level in him so high that they believe he'll get out of it and make plays for them to win a game?
Well, they've said they believe in him. That's being tested right here. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Well, they brought the pressure, and that meant man coverage behind him, so he's still able to complete the pass.
Even as he took the hit. And that's what you have to do, because I was just talking with a coach the other day, and he said, look, it's not always going to be pretty back there. You're going to have to give me completions. Even when you're taking some hits, sometimes you have to be your own blitz control, for lack of a better term. Got to make completion, step up and make those throws, and he did that.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll go down at the 28. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine.
Check it hungry. Check 26. Check him.
On first down, Way. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in this football game. And he'll take this inside the 30 to about the 29, maybe the 28-yard line. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout as the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game. The Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on third down. He can run for it, and he will. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It's a gain of 12, and the Cowboys pick up the first.
A gain of 12, and the Cowboys first down.
Oh, now look at this. They're lining up to add 3 more, a little insult to injury here late in the game. A 33-yarder from the left hash. A lot of scoring. There's no doubt about that in this one, Charles. Points, they were not at a premium. They were pretty easy to come by.
They were, but it was fun, wasn't it? Because both teams finding ways to click. And you know people who love this game, they also love baseball games that are 14-11 with 3 or 4 home runs mixed in.
So for Dallas, they close out this first half at a very...
Okay. time to bring the bass bird. Sir, I'm going big like a lineman. She want bring the limes in. She want to pull up to the crib, we can't dine in. Up right away, couldn't even get a bind in. Straight with the money, we aligned in. Tell me how he broke, tryna chime in. Jesus watching over here in diamonds. He the only reason why I do not get violent. Hey, give me patience. Hey, swear to God, make sense.